The Zoo is, I think, is the signature song for Animal Magnetism. It's until today a song we play at every show. It's so popular around the world, and it still gets in its original version. We have a couple of different versions now. Gets in its original version a lot of airplay in the States until today, and it is it reflects, you know, a young German band going to the United States and you know, working the inspirations into their music.
The Zoo was really something where you can say there's a story behind, which in it comes on different direction. One direction was a musical direction, which actually I composed the song in front of the TV by watching the not a hurricane, tornado alarm. So, and by watching a tornado alarm, which the tornado came directly in front of us, and then I played a riff. And by when the alarm was finished, not that the alarm was finished, but an announcer was gone, I listened what I played. I played. I said, "Oh, that's great." So, and there again, what I said before, there was a red line. I start immediately to lock in, and there was the song done. So, but on the other hand, when I played the song in the evening, we went like always to the concert in the dressing room, and I went to Klaus' dressing room. I said, "Klaus, okay, no, in these days we had everybody's dressing room together. Five guys in one dressing room." I said, "Here, Klaus, listen to this one." "Oh, yeah, great. That's a fantastic one."
I remember that when we were just signed to our label in New York City with Mercury Records and with our managers, Labor Krebs, one night they said, "Guys, we're going to take you out. We go to the Zoo tonight, you know." And this was the inspiration for the song. We didn't know, where do we go? To the Zoo? Yeah, let's go to the Zoo. And turned out it was like, you know, the clubs around 42nd Street. And so it had a nice visual. You know, you saw the Zoo and all those people walking by and all those, this kind of strange and dangerous vibe late at night being out there. And that's what I try to express in that song. And it was very much the very first strong reflection we got from playing in America.
And yeah, Klaus came up with the lyrics and everything fit together until to the point where I noticed one moment, did it, somehow that's not the right beginning. And I remember in the hotel, this was in Atlanta, a Peachtree Plaza hotel, a round hotel out of glass. And I had, I think, a lunch, and there were some American guys there, and there were also few girls from meditation center, and that talking about something like this, very inspiring. So I went up there in my apartment later and started fiddling around and stuff, and somehow I saw a helicopter in front of me, but the same helicopter was on TV. So now what's happening? I hear the TV, the announcer guy said, "And here you see from up here, we have the bank robbery happening." And so, and there was, it was unbelievable, because I could see everything from, I think, how many floors were there. There was like 40 or 60 or what, I don't know how many floors, but very high. And you're watching the helicopter who's talking about the bank robbery down there, what the TV is telling you. In this case, in the moment, I was doing this. That was the beginning. And that's the tension between the whole both things. That's the directly powerful thing which I got from this bank robbery. And then cool down.
It is a signature sound as well. It has that dragging groove and the darkness to a certain extent, and the voice box, which makes it special.
You try to express all your feelings and emotions in what was coming out in your word of creativity, you know, and that was so inspiring. And the zoo had this kind of vibe and everything, like the music and the talk box and this whole thing, and together with the words, it made like a perfect match. You know, we eat the night, we drink the time, make our dreams come true on streets we call the zoo. You know, it was great. It's really stands for that moment in time.
Dieter Dierks even went over to record something on the original 42nd Street, because at the very end of in the fade out of the original version from Animal Magnetism, there's the sound collage, which was authentically recorded by Dieter Dierks in the street. He flew over especially for that. And you even hear, like, in the very end, you hear, like, cocaine, you know, some of the drug dealers and the street noise.
You hear the kind of,
So he made a collage out of all the things he had recorded. This is what you did back then.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.